Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to bring in our boxers for Redemption Due. Please welcome from Japan, Kasunari Takayama.
Kasunari Takayama, the only Japanese to fight for the IBF title. Making his way to the ring, the Japanese are the last country, the only country that do not recognize the IBF. But this man is the only Japanese. If he wins tonight, he will be the first Japanese IBF champion. As he makes his way into the ring, making his second visit to South Africa. Show us a thing or two, this man. It's not Takayama yet, he's only making his way into the ring now. Some support from Japan, the land of the rising sun. Look at that! The man from the land of the rising sun.
The opponent, the man who hails from Buffalo City, put your hands together for Nkosinasi Joye!
That's the man from the Eastern Cape. Arrived yesterday for this fight. Obviously, that's another tactic to beat altitude. It's gonna be a tough fight. It's gonna be a very tough fight tonight.
Oh yes, no doubt. That's an Aussie Joy, 28-year-old South African. They carry his IPF belt, his South African belt, and the, I don't believe, the IPO belt. South African belt, the IBO belt, and the IBF belt. The young man carrying the belt is Magnus Sinyadi, carrying the IBF belt, and Dete carrying the IBO belt.
So they're all homeboys. And the other boys still have to work hard to get to own those titles.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we do all the introductions, as we get our flag into the ring, let us please be upstanding for the national anthems. First of all, the national anthem of Japan. National anthem of South Africa. IBF World Mini Flyweight Championship, scheduled for 12 rounds. Your judges, first of all, let me introduce them to you once again. From the USA, John Trella. From Switzerland, Beat Hausmann. And making up the final judge, he's from Cape Town, Isaac Shabalala. Now, the supervisor once again from Tanzania for this IBF encounter is none other than Onesmo Ngowi. Now, when the bell rings and the action begins, in this, the square ring, the third man will be none other than the Fairest Capes referee, Dion Duarte. Introducing the principals to you right now. This gentleman weighed in at 47.6 kilograms. He's wearing the silver trunks. He's the IBF mandatory challenger. Pound for pound, Ring Magazine rates him as number 8. He's the former WBC and WBA world champion. 28 fights with 24 wins, 10 by knockout. He's only lost 4. He hails from Osaka, Japan. Make him feel nice, warm, and welcome, Katsunari Takayama. His opponent weighed in at 47.54 kilograms. He's wearing the dark blue trunks. His record stands at 21 with 21 wins, 15 by knockout. Pound for pound, Ring Magazine rates him number 2 in the world. And I must also tell you, he's brought along a supporter tonight, all the way from Buffalo City, where she is the mayor. Behind me up here, we welcome Mrs. Zukiza Faku, who's supporting her man here tonight, Nkosinathi Mabera Joy. Boxers.
Okay, I've given you your instructions in the dressing room. Obey my commands all times, protect yourself at all times, okay? Shake hands, good luck, and God bless.
From referee Duarte. Let's have a look how these two men shape up.
Right, the height is going the South African's way, so we will definitely get to see what Katsunari Takayama is going to do with the fact that he has a height disadvantage going into the fight. Let's go.
Well, unbeaten Nkosinathi Joy tonight here. Defense is startled only for the first time. And Katsunari, I must tell you, is no stranger to this ring. He was here in September last year, on the 1st of September 2010, to fight an eliminator against Tepo Lefele from South Africa. Nkosinathi Joy, a durable young man with power, with punching power, second to none. Well, a man who attested that is Mexican Raul Garcia, against whom he fought for the IBF title and won. And early in this round, we saw Takayama tapping with Joy, throwing good punches. Really, good punch! And Joy goes in!
This is going to be a very tough fight. This is going to be a long night for the Japanese.
And Joy is chasing his man around the ring. From Osaka, Japan, the land of the rising sun.
Katsunari Takayama
taking a great deal of punishment in round number 1.
Yeah, just trying to adjust to what Joy is going to have to do in the ring. I mean, this is not vintage Takayama at all, because he's not a moving boxer, but he is forced into that style because of the punches he's taken in the first minute of this fight.
And Joey, as a measure of his man, is able to use those long arms to keep his man at bay. Natural minimum weight. Joey's never had to drop weight before. The Japanese take the lead. And I'm just walking on fire. Now I'm Bonzeleka. What's wrong with Bonzeleka? He just had a
bomb. Take a look at that. That very predictable movement, because he's not used to doing it. Takayama is going to have to find a different way of just stepping outside. Step outside, drop a straight right.
Another big punch! Oh, another one! Stagnation backward! This could be the end! This could be the end!
I can tell you right now that Takayama does not belong in the same ring as Nkosi Natichoy.
The last time when he was here, Nkosi Natichoy, he did say he was a dream starter that night. As we come to the end of round one, a round totally dominated by Joey.
Alright, let's take a look at round number one. How did it go? Takayama was keen to get involved in close quarters, but it soon became very hot inside there. Take a look at that. Natichoy hasn't done nothing special here other than really to dig deep, sit on his punches, look for his opponent. Takayama has been taken out of his game plan completely. So let's see what's going to happen in round two.
Round number two.
IBF started when some officials walked out of the WBA convention and Robert Lee did not win the president of the WBA, walked out and formed the IBF, an American-based organization.
Okay, let's look at Katsunari Takayama. What is his game plan?
There's no game plan at all.
So, he's got to throw. He's got to close the distance. Got to fight him inside the pocket. And there, he's got a problem. The problem is called a right hook and it's called a left uppercut. That is the problem at close quarters. Some crisp short punches by Nkosi Natichoy. But at a distance like this, Joy still out jabs him. Even if he has to throw straight punches, he will definitely win the fight at a distance. So, I would say that Takayama has to really, he should have been an incredibly gifted boxer in terms of skill if he's to outthink Nkosi Natichoy in this fight.
WBA title and twice he lost. And tonight here he's trying to become the first Japanese boxer to win an IBF title. He lost the WBA world minimum title against Roman Gonzalez. Now he's trying to mix it up with Joey. Joey's really dominating his man early in this fight. Chasing his man now, wants to make finish this fight early.
lot of big boxers and fighters from these areas, like Japan, the Philippines, love to drop over on rights and really get stuck in. He is looking for the right hand, but it's just not getting there right now.
10 seconds!
10 seconds to the end of round number two. Katsunari Takayama trying to look up, trying to work out a game plan for this fight.
Bambe, Kaukse, and
But you can see the impact of his straight left. Takayama really out of sorts here. Probably coming out of this big break here. Okay, let's see what's going to happen in round number three. Can Takayama Mtakazi step up the pace, shift to the next gear, and see if he can meet Joey at that level?
Well, it's complete sheer braveness from Takayama. And he has no plan, really. He is square coming forward. There is no other way you can use except for running around. And Joey says to him, you can run around, but you can't hide. Goes to the body. Closes very well, Takayama. Joey goes to the body again.
Takayama doesn't like body punches. We saw that in the fight against Lefele, that he was uncomfortable with those kind of punches.
Joey chasing his man around the ring, completely in control.
I think Joey has definitely met some tough opponents than Takayama.
Well, he has a tough opponent. I can talk to you about Sammy Gutierrez.
Sammy Gutierrez, definitely.
Condes.
Condes. But Gutierrez definitely had Joey thinking a heck of a lot in the ring and really changing the game plan at all times. Although he was stopped by Joey in round number seven, but he definitely offered Joey a lot of lessons in the ring.
No doubt. Takayama has decided to stay on the outside. Punch. Oh, another one straight through. That's those defenses. Oh, no, 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 no,
no, no, no, no. How the referee is going to declare. Legas, if that is declared an accidental clash of hands,
the fight give you a chance.
And it's a non-intentional foul. It's a non-intentional foul.
Accidental.
Accidental, you hear that. So,
accidental,
there's a reason they're saying that.
Accidental, eh?
Because that rule is going to come into place.
Accidental.
Well, that's rule number. If it is accidental foul, cause an injury, it's severe enough for the referee to stop the foul immediately. The bout will result in a no decision.
Yes.
It's stopped before 4 hours. That's the end of it. It's a no decision.
Accidental headbutt.
It's a no decision.
Definitely is a no decision. It's a no decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, we await the official announcement.
Accidental foul.
If an accidental foul causes an injury severe enough for the referee to stop the bout immediately, the bout will result in a no decision. If stopped before 4 rounds completed, 4 rounds are complete when the bell rings. Signifying the end of the 4 rounds. So this is a long decision.
definitely is. What that means for you at home, fight fans, is that the South African keeps his world championship.
Yes, it does. It keeps his world championship. And the young man from Japan, the game young man from Japan, can try another day.
Yeah, they'll probably give him another opportunity. But in my view, I think Joey would be better served by going to search for some other, some greener pasture. Let's take a look at that again from another angle. Take a look at that. Takayama coming in to engage. Then they turn him there. There's a clash of heads. Definitely an accidental clash of heads there. The fight has ended.
The blood was oozing out of that clash, that opening on the side of the head. Brian Mulder will give us the decision.
Referee Duwadi stops his bout. 1 minute 59 seconds in round three. The IBF bout has been declared a no contest.
There you go then.